Virginia Jean with an SOS call. Over.
Robert Redford calls his new movie, All Is Lost, pure cinema.
No dialogue, no barriers between you and the viewing audience. I like that.
This movie is a journey and all Redford, but we don't know his character's name, his backstory, and we almost never hear him speak. A mere three lines of dialogue in almost 2 hours of film.
It was more like a silent movie, and I like that. I like the idea of, can you tell a story without having any dialogue? You should be able to do that, and this gave you the chance.
One topic the acclaimed actor and director can't stay silent on, the real-life political drama playing out in D.C.
You know, it's funny because we could almost name All Is Lost what's been going on in Washington.
Well, don't get me started
right
on that.
But I wanted to ask you because the last time we spoke, President Obama had just been reelected, and we were talking about what you wanted to see for his second term. What do you see right now, and what do you think so far?
Well, what I wanted to see was is turning out to be a bit of a dream that never came true. I don't envy his position. I think he's a good man. I think he's an intelligent man, a compassionate man who can't function in that environment. That environment, it is so decrepit. It is so paralyzed. And the worst of it is that it's paralyzed by intention. There's a body of congressional people that want to paralyze the system. I think what sits underneath it, unfortunately, is there's probably some racism involved, which is really awful.
Is that the elephant in the room that nobody wants to talk about?
I think, well, I don't know where it's an elephant. It's some kind of animal.
snake?
It's in the room. Yeah, whatever it is, I think it's in the room. But there are other issues. It's not just racism. I think it's a group of people that are so afraid of change. And they're so narrow-minded that when you see some people, when you see change coming, get so threatened by change, they get angry and they get terrorized and then they get vicious.
Is that change universal health care? Is that change having someone that doesn't look like the norm as the leader of the free world?
Doesn't look like the norm,
yeah,
in their mind. But I think just the idea of giving credit to this president, giving him credit for anything, is abhorrent to them, so they'll go against it. Never mind that it's for the better good of the people. Never mind that they're supposed to be in office representing the interests of the public. They're representing their own self-interests, which are very narrow and in some cases just bigoted.